Hey there, I'm Kimberly with Basecamp's Customer Success team, and I want to walk you through how to work with clients inside of Basecamp. We hear from a lot of customers who are using Basecamp just for their internal team, but are still using other tools like email to communicate with their clients. And I get it. But I have to be honest, clients with Basecamp is one of my favorite aspects of the product. I've mentioned it before, but prior to working at Basecamp, I was an event planner, and each of my clients had their own separate Basecamp project that they had access to. Other than in-person or online meetings, Basecamp was really the main way I would communicate with our clients about their event. Don't send me an email, don't send me a text, put it in Basecamp. It's so helpful for storing everything in one place and keeping all communication with clients on the record, so you can easily find it and refer back to it if needed. In this video, I'm going to show you not only how to get your clients into Basecamp, but also how you can control what they see once they're there. Before we get started, I think it's most helpful to get your project set up the way you want it to be structured before you invite your client into your account. So figure out what tools you want your project to have. You can change, rename, and duplicate tools with a three-dot menu at the top right from inside a project. Your client won't be able to change the project tools or rename them, so you're totally in control of how your project is structured. And not to worry, if you decide to add a tool or rename a tool later, you can totally do that too. Now, to get a client into your Basecamp project, you need to first give your project client access. You'll click Add Some People, and then from this screen, select Add a Client to this project. You'll type in the name of the client's company and select Next. If you already have clients added into your Basecamp account, you can select them here. But if this is the first time you're adding someone to Basecamp, you'll have to first invite them into your account before you can add them to this project. Click Invite People to Your Account from the pop-up. And just a note here, you can add people to your account from your home screen as well with the green Invite People button. From either place, you'll end up right here where you'll choose who this person is you're inviting in. You'll want to indicate that the person you're adding is a client you're working for. This is the most important part of the setup, as this is the only option where you can control what this person sees. If someone is added into your account in any other way, they have full access to all parts of the project. They can see all the messages, all the to-dos, all the everything. So if you're wanting to hide anything from a client or have conversations with your internal team that the client can't see, make sure you have them identified as a client when you invite them in. You'll enter in their name, email address, and the client's company, which will pop up as you start to enter it since you've already added it into your account. You can add more than one person at a time with a green plus button. Click Email Invitation Now, and Basecamp will send an email to the client so that they can set up a password to access your account. While that's happening, you'll want to select which projects your client can access. You'll check the project you want them to see and then save. Just a note here, only projects that have client access turned on will show up here. So if you're wanting to invite someone you've identified as a client into a project and you don't see that project on the list, you'll need to go back a step and turn on client access for the project. On your home screen, you'll see the client's company name on the project card just above the name of the project. So it's easy to see that that project has clients invited to it. When you open the project, you'll also see the client's avatar at the top, an indication that they are the client, as well as a yellow circle around the avatar. Now, at this point, you've given your client access to your Basecamp account and you've added them to a project, but they can't see anything. And that's because everything in a project is private by default. You have to flip a switch to let the client be able to see it. Let me show you. Let's start with the message board. When you post a new message, you'll see a note at the top asking who should be allowed to see this message. It's automatically set to private, but if you'd like the client to be able to see it, you'll select Allow the client to see this too. The yellow indicator at the top lets you know that it's visible to the client. From the message board tool, you'll also be able to tell which messages the client can see. Any messages without the yellow highlight are private to your team only. With to-do lists, the process is the same. When you add a new to-do list, you'll see the area at the top where you can change the to-do list from private to shared with the client. This works really well if you wanted to have a to-do list for tasks the client can see, and then a private to-do for internal tasks, like onboarding the client or even accounting tasks. When a to-do list is private, the client can't see if someone adds a to-do to the list comments on the to-do, or completes a to-do. They only see the to-do lists that have been shared with them. Let's look at docs and files. When you upload something to this part of a project, you'll see an area at the top asking who should be allowed to see this file. If it's private, the client won't ever see this file or even know that it exists. If you share it with them, they'll be able to comment on it, download it, the works. When you add an event to the schedule, you'll have the option to show it to the client or keep it private with your team. You won't even be able to add a client to an event on the schedule until you switch that event to being shared. From the schedule page, you'll see that yellow indicator again, so you'll know what the client can see and what they can't. Let's head over to the campfire. One thing to know here is that you can't make individual comments in a campfire, either private or client-facing, but you can select if the entire campfire tool is private or not. So if you wanted to keep the campfire chat just private for your team, you can do that. Or if you want clients to be able to chat with you, you could open up access for them. You could even add a separate campfire to your project if you wanted to, one that the client can access and one that's completely separate for your team. That yellow indicator carries over throughout your Basecamp project, so there's no confusion on what the client can see and what they can't. Now, before I wrap up, I just want to clarify that even though we use the word client here at Basecamp, you can really invite anyone into your account with this client category if you want to control what they can see and what they can't inside of a project. For example, we've seen teachers who are setting up their students as clients, or company staff adding executives into the account as clients. Or let's say you're a nonprofit and you use Basecamp to manage your day-to-day tasks. You could set up your volunteers in Basecamp as clients and control what parts of the project the client can see. That client category simply lets you limit visibility to parts of your project, so don't let that title get you stuck. Now, I hope that all helps. If you have any questions as you're getting started and adding clients into your account, you can reach out to me or the rest of the customer success team by sending an email to guides@basecamp.com.